I'm going to discuss a very controversial topic today, which is the importance of a college degree in building a data science or coding career. In the end of the video, I will discuss some of the real life cases of those people who build a great career in coding or data science without a relevant college degree. And we will divide this video in two sections. First, we'll discuss the situation in US or European countries, and then we'll talk about the situation in India. So let's first see what big entrepreneurs like Elon Musk has to say on the importance of a college degree.
There's no need even to have a college degree.
Oh, okay.
At all, or even high school. If somebody graduated from a great university, that may be an indication that they will be capable of great things, but it's not necessarily the case. If you look at, say, people like Bill Gates or Larry Ellison, Steve Jobs, these guys didn't graduate from college. But if you had a chance to hire them, of course, that would be a good idea.
Yeah.
I was reading this article on Business Insider where Apple CEO Tim Cook said that you don't need a college degree in order to become successful. In fact, majority of the Apple's employee that they hire don't have four-year degree. Tim Cook is saying that this because he sees a big mismatch between the skills that are learned in college and the skills which are required in the industry. So you can read through the article to understand his reasoning on why college degrees are not as important as you think they are. Also on Glassdoor, which is an employer review website, there was this article where they listed 15 companies where you don't need a college degree in order to get hired. And these companies are Google, Ernst & Young, Costco, Whole Foods, Apple. So these are some of the big names that they are hiring without any college degree, and they look at certain other aspects which we'll discuss a little later, but college degree is not as important. If you go to YouTube, search for importance of college degree in coding career, you will find many examples. For example, this video where many successful people like Mark Zuckerberg, Warren Buffett, they explain why college degrees are useless. There is this video by this lady who became a software engineer without a computer science degree. Right now there are many boot camps, like 2 month or 3 month boot camps, which you can take, learn coding and get hired as a software developer. I'm looking at a Google software engineer position in Bangalore, India, and their minimum qualification is bachelor degree in computer science or equivalent practical experience. Now this is important. What does equivalent practical experience means? So I went to Quora to read this insightful article where they say, okay, do you need a degree to get hired in Google? And couple of folks from Google, see, this person is working at Google and he's replying saying that you don't need a college degree to get hired at Google. There's other person who replied and explained that the meaning of equivalent practical experience, what they're saying is by combination of looking at your resume to see what you have already done in your career so far, which means your freelancing project, open source contribution, Kaggle, coding competition, whatever. If they realize that your experience is equivalent to you earning a degree, they would call you for an interview. And if you perform in the interview, they would hire you. Now, many of you would argue with me that, okay, these things are good in US, but in India, situation is different. Most of the employers are asking for bachelor's in computer science degree. Well, I agree. They're asking for the degree today, but things are changing very, very fast. And let me mention few examples which happen in India. So recently I came across a LinkedIn post where a person, his name is Abdul. He was a security guard in this company called Zoho in Chennai. And he learned HTML, CSS and web programming on his own, and he got hired as a software engineer. He completed 8 years in Zoho as a software engineer, very successful software engineer. He's only 10th pass. He doesn't have any college degree. He was a security guard in the company. Okay, so please read through his inspirational LinkedIn post so that you get a confidence that even in India, people are hiring without college degree. Second example is Tanul Singh, who was a mechanical engineer, And during his BTech in mechanical engineering, he picked up the interest in data science. Then he goes on to Kaggle and he keeps on practicing and he earns a good rank on Kaggle. And then he directly gets a job as a data scientist. His first job after mechanical engineering is a data scientist job. He doesn't have any computer science degree, data science degree, just based on his Kaggle performance. So you realize that based on Kaggle performance, Stack Overflow, community participation, such as open source, you know, participating in conferences, all these activities help you make your resume very strong so that you can get a job. Tanul Singh got a job in India, by the way. All these examples that I'm mentioning are in India. He got a job as a data scientist. Eventually, he became an ML engineer. Machine learning engineer is a little complex. You know, you need to have a computer science degree. But here's the person, real life example. I did a video with him. I strongly suggest you watch a video that I did with Tanul Singh to get an idea on, you know, how he made this transition. The third example I want to mention is one of my subscribers. He is a boy living in a small town of Rajasthan, India. And this person started freelancing on Upwork when he was in a third year of his computer science engineering. Now, although he was in a college, he barely manages to pass. You know, he gets maybe 50% in his college studies. He told to me when I talk with him on phone that he's not learning anything from his college. He learned all the coding on his own. So although he's in computer science degree, even if he was not going to college, he would be doing still good on Upwork. He used to earn 1 lakh rupees a month 5 years back. Right now he's earning much more than that. He's top rated freelancer on Upwork. The person who did not learn anything from college, and he learned everything on his own using YouTube videos and internet, and very successful freelancer. He's earning much more than what you can earn in your regular job. Now, I mentioned only three examples. I interact with so many people on my YouTube channel. So many of my subscribers have these successful stories, and I'm seeing many examples today. Friends, trust me, many examples today where people don't have a relevant degree or they don't have a degree and they are getting a job, they are building a successful career. I agree, still there are many companies who are stringent. They will say, oh no, you need to have a degree, otherwise you're not getting interview call. As of 2021, this is the situation, but the situation is changing very fast. More and more companies are becoming open-minded. So in next 5 years, we will see a trend where significant amount of companies will not require you to have a college degree if you want to build a career in data science or computer programming. Because the way this works is FANG companies, you know, Google, Facebook, Amazon, they set some example and rest of the companies, they follow them, right? This happened in the case of cloud. FANG companies started doing cloud, you know, a few years back. And now every company, they are all on Amazon, Google Cloud, Azure. FANG companies started data science, AI, you know, 2-3 years back. Now every company, you know, TCS, Infosys, every service-based company is doing AI, data science, AI, data science. So you have already seen this trend that FANG companies will do something and this rest of the companies, you know, they will just follow them. So if you are in Bangalore, Google, you know, Google Bangalore, when they hire, they don't need a college degree. The rest of the companies, if they're not following these FANG companies today, in next few years, they have to follow. Otherwise, they'll be out of the competition. I want to take a moment and leave this quick message about my brother's company, Atlic Technologies, which is a software development and digital marketing company based in Gujarat, India. Atlic Technologies provide services in terms of software development, mobile app development, data analytics, AI, digital marketing, RPA development, business consulting, etc. You can check the project portfolio here. They have built projects for many international clients and they have a team of more than 60 talented engineers who can build a high quality software for you. So if you or anyone whom you know is interested in doing a software development or digital marketing services, click on contact button and fill out a quick form. It will take you only 5 seconds and someone will get back to you. We need to understand the situation from a recruiter standpoint as well. let's say a good company is hiring with a good perks and benefits, and then for one position they might get 50 resumes. Now they have to use some criteria to filter those resumes, right? They can't just call all 50 people for an interview. So if you don't have a college degree and if you don't have any special achievement such as special Kaggle rank, open source contribution, freelancing, coding challenges, etc., then of course you will not get an interview call. You have to do a lot of hard work. There is no shortcut. So if you don't have any of the special achievements and college degree, and if you're not getting an interview call, well, it's obvious there is something missing. You need to have something special in your resume that catches the recruiter's eyes. Networking on LinkedIn is important. Getting referrals from the employees who are working in that company is another important thing, and then we can have a discussion separately on all these topics. But you need to do all these activities, friends, otherwise you're not going to get an interview call. And you know, like people say that, okay, I don't have a college degree, you're teaching false motivation. But it's not false motivation. I have mentioned the real life examples. There are many benefits of going to college. When you go to college, you make friends, you have fun, you participate in sports activities. Now when we participate in sports and activity, let's say I am managing some cultural activity, I will learn a lot of soft skills such as team management, ego management, conflict resolution, how to do project planning, you know, event planning. These skills are extremely useful when you build a career. Even if you are becoming a programmer, you will get a lot of benefits of these soft skills that you learn during the college. If you are participating in sports, you are very good in sports, then you have fighting spirits, you know the rules of the game, you know. And working in a company, working on a project, you also like a game, and you need to understand how you can win that game. So going to college has all these beautiful advantages that you can benefit from. But my point is, if you don't have money to afford college education, then don't worry. Even without college education, you can build successful career. You need to be disciplined, you need to do certain other activities. The disadvantages that I see personally going to college are following. Number one, many times the college curriculum is outdated. As of 2021, you will find many colleges which are not teaching Python, for example, which are not teaching the things which are happening in the industry. They're still teaching an old or deprecated legacy technologies. The second problem is the teachers or professors, many times they have not worked in the industry, so they don't have that industry exposure and they cannot, you know, connect well with the industry. There are great teachers, you know, all the time who can teach theory well, but when it comes to practical, if you have not worked in the industry, it becomes difficult, you know, to teach from that industry mindset perspective. The biggest problem that I see with the college is not with the college, it is with the student itself. I was approached by a college recently where they said that there are some 600 people, you know, computer science students who wants to hear from me on data science career. So they arranged a webinar. I went on the webinar and I was expecting 600 people, but what I saw was only 35 people attending it. And I immediately realized that only 35 people are genuinely interested. Remaining people are doing computer engineering just because maybe their parents told them to do computer engineering. In countries like India especially, your parents, your friends, your uncles, aunties will say, hey, your kids should become computer engineer because my neighbor's son is working in Amazon earning 30 lakh rupees a year. And for that reason, your son should also become a computer engineer. But they don't look at person's interests, the skills, etc. There is this famous Bollywood movie called Three Idiots where they say, if you try to teach cricket to Lata Mangeshkar, who is a famous singer, or if you try to teach singing to Sachin Tendulkar, who is a famous cricketer, they both would be a horrible failure because that's not their passion. Problem with colleges is that students become computer science engineer or mechanical engineer just because someone else decided that future for them. They themselves are either not interested or maybe they're not clear on what they want to do. But let's say if I'm not clear what I want to do, why should I commit myself into 4-year college degree? 4-year college degree is a big commitment. And now you do 4-year computer engineering. After 4th year, you realize you are good in sales. So maybe you want to become a salesman. Then you have just wasted your 4 years. So that you kind of get the point. The students enrolling in the degree, they don't give enough thought. And that becomes a reason why spending time in colleges becomes useless or worthless almost. So I hope you liked the opinion that I shared in this video. If you have any questions or comments, please post in a comment box below. Also, if you have seen any successful stories where people build a great career without a college degree or without a relevant college degree, please mention those stories in the video comment below. Maybe I can interview them on my channel at some future point. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you like this, and if you did, please give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends.